is a book review of Daredevil, A Man Without Fear. This is an artifact edition, slightly different from the artist edition. Artist editions include all of the story. They've got every page, in most cases. And in this, it's sometimes just like one or two pages per thing. Now, this book came out in 2015. It's from IDW. They've been bringing out loads and loads of these volumes. I'm not certain how many they've been bringing out recently, of course, with COVID, etc. There's obviously been a bit of a slowdown, I suspect, with all those sort of things. But they brought out loads. There's lots of these brilliant ones. And this one, Daredevil one, well, I loved the Daredevil when the series was going. Obviously, Frank Miller's Daredevil, 158 all the way through to about 191. I love that period of Daredevil. So I had to buy this book. So now I'm just going to run through. It's about 160 pages. Most of these ones always seem to be about 160 pages. And this has got, obviously, say, not every page. So you've got like Daredevil 159. You've only got pages 14 and 18. Does make for a slightly disconnect, obviously broken down story. You're not getting, but if you've read them before, of course, hopefully at some point Marvel will bring out an epic collection. Or obviously there's an omnibus edition available. And, you know, and also the original comics are still readily available, though I suspect some of the early ones, etc., are expensive. So you've got Daredevil 168, it's got a lot of pages, about 10 pages. Daredevil 181, you've got there, that's got quite a lot of pages as well. So you've got near enough the complete story there, like 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13, 17, etc. And then you've got the art there. And I just love this. Now, this one is obviously where Matt first meets Elektra. Just a beautiful bit of artwork there. Actually, a more traditional art bit of artwork there. Likewise with the arms of the octopus. And it's more standard panels. I mean, it got quite more unusual, I think, doing it later. But I just love the use of panels. I love the thin panels, all those sort of varying the panels. There's quite a lot of panels on this page. So you've got there. This is with the Kingpin. And you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 panels. Oh, I should show you also the spine. There's this one. It's a real nice quality there. And then you go to another page. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's just straight across. So you did vary the gauntlet. Gauntlet? Okay. But you've got Elektra. It's got obviously the martial arts, all the stories that thing. And then I just think some of the brilliant, the inking is just superb. We've got obviously Your Friend is Dead. And also, when you look at this, it's how many pages? Very little actual word balloons. There's some pages virtually all silent. There's like one here, King, it's it. King, that's it. Oh, it's King, obviously, the actual words that people are saying, but it's very, very, very quiet. You've got the, even when he whacks that character there, again, not much to say. There's hardly any word balloons on that. Just some awesome pages here. Now, these ones are actually quite brown, actually. I don't know how the storage of these ones, but they're actually quite, now they haven't sort of obviously super, super cleaned them up in any shape or form. They've obviously scanned them, and what you get is what you get. So you get, but unfortunately with this, compared with some of, say, like the Jack Kirby ones, Jack Kirby one, you get quite a bit of writing and stuff. There's not excessive amount of writing. Obviously, Klaus Johnson there, the inker. But it's, you know, you really look at it and it's very, very clean. You've got some pages where you can see it a lot whiter than others. Obviously, they've been stored a lot better than some others. You've got the Kingpin there just looking dramatic. And again, you've got page after page after page of just brilliant artwork. You've got some lovely, also, 5 million will die. Dr. Octopus threatens the city with, etc. And you also got, so you've got the actual comics, of course, but you've also got the covers as well. So this one's Daredevil 161, the cover of. And some you've got the covers, but without any of the surrounding sort of blurb, all the Daredevil, etc., and the little box in the corner. So you've got the Daredevil there, Daredevil Goes Berserk, this one there, Daredevil 177, This one's Daredevil 179, along with Elektra holding up Matt's Daredevil mask, and so on and so on. You've even got like the Wolverine in here, so it's not all just Daredevil. So even though it says Daredevil there, you've got the Frank Miller's Wolverine there. And then you've got some more pin-ups as well. This one here, you've got pin-up with Buy This Book one, or Face the Wrath of the Dreaded Dharmamu. Dharmamu, never say his name right. My apologies to him. He'll probably blast me from his dreaded dimension. And you've got Bullseye there, and so on and so on. You've also got a biography at the back of Frank Miller. Now, I'm always quite surprised. I don't think I've seen a Frank Miller big, massive Art of Frank Miller book. Must check out that out. Wouldn't surprise. I would have thought someone, some enterprise in Seoul would have brought, like the Woodwork series from IDW, John Buscema one, they brought out Steve Ditko. You'd have thought Frank Miller would have had a huge volume of his work come out like that. But however, it's just great when these sort of books, because I loved this thing, and it's just one of those books you just pick up and just admire the superb artwork. And that's the thing you get with these artist editions, or artifact edition in this case, is just looking at the artwork as close and as detailed really as you're ever going to get. Now, of course, sometimes, strange enough, when you get the omnibus editions and things, it looks even cleaner. But this is the closest you're ever going to really get. And it's, I think it's just superb. Now, it's just always a pity when you look at these pages that they weren't stored away even better, because there's obviously clearly some brown in there that they've, but they're still amazing. It's really good that they still exist, which is the key thing, because obviously a lot of early stuff, early 60s and 70s, and obviously 1940s, 1950s comics, there's just not really that much material available of these inked pages. Again, of course, what would be nice would be the pencil pages. I would love to see the pencil pages of these, but clearly, unless they've been scanned at the time when they were being produced, then they've been, that's sort of lost underneath the inking. But these are brilliant books. Really hope that IDW keep bringing out more and more of these brilliant volumes. And I will certainly pick up not all of them. Sometimes they bring out ones that I'm not, I won't get that one, but some I think, wow. And this definitely is that in the wow category. Totally brilliant, superb book.